What's up, everyone? This is Corey again for vlog number 6 of the Perfectly Imperfect vlog challenge. And today I am going to tell you a story about my cat Luna. Basically how I found her, how I got her, and yeah, and that's it. How she became who she is right now and her spunky personality. So one day I was driving on, I think it's Imagineers Boulevard, going towards the beach. Actually, I just finished going towards the beach. I was coming back home, going eastbound towards Sepulveda Boulevard. And when I passed Sepulveda, Sepulveda is a very busy street. So is Imagineers Boulevard. They're like main streets. And as I was driving, I passed Sepulveda. I see this little black thing in the street, and I see this big, I think it's a Ford Explorer or maybe a Suburban, drive right over it. And when I come up to it, I see these two eyes right here looking right at me. And at the time, Luna was 3 months, maybe just 3 months old. So she was very small. She's like the size of my hand, but she fit in the size of my hand. I looked at her, I stopped the car right in the middle of the street, put on my hazard brakes, ran out there, grabbed her, and I put her in the seat with my old dog, Gizmo, that passed away. And then right away, I took her to the vet that was right around the corner. And then I was just gonna just try to give it to the vet and say, hey, can you guys find a place for it or whatever? But I took her there. I said, we can't take her, but we'll check her, see how she is. And when they checked her, she was okay. She was just dehydrated. So I took her home at 3 months. I'll show you a picture right now. So when I took her home, brought her home, I contacted some rescues, some places, because I didn't need a cat, because I had my dog, Gizmo, who at the time was 12 years old. And at the time, she was, three months, so I didn't need another animal, and I didn't feel want to keep her. So what happened was, actually a few weeks later, my dog Gizmo had a heart problem, and it was basically time for us to put Gizmo to sleep. So it was kind of a, I don't know what you call it. So I felt like I had to keep her because she came in when Gizmo was leaving. So I felt like Gizmo was like, oh, you found her, so I think it's okay if I leave now, you'll be okay. So that's how I took it. So I kept this crazy black cat. And yeah, so one of the things is when we had her, when she was a baby, her back tail was kind of cut. We didn't know what was wrong with it. The vet didn't say anything. So I took her to the vet, another vet, and then they said, oh, if it grows, it's fine, but it doesn't smell like it's dying or anything. So basically, she had a piece of this tail, I think it was that long at the time, and it basically, I don't think it was growing. So one day I was feeding her, and she was all about food at the time. So I gave her the food, and she darted for the food, and I didn't know, I put my knee on her tail and the tail popped off. So I had one of her tail was this long, and she was just there eating like nothing happened. That's why she has this short little tail. And yeah, she really didn't care. So I was like kind of panicked. I was like, oh crap. I grabbed Wendy. I was like, hey, we gotta go to the vet because her tail's right here and she's right here and she's just chilling and she's eating. But we took her to the vet. The vet looked at it like they couldn't do anything. So they basically stitched her tail up and she was all good. And yeah, that's one of the crazy stories I found of her. And maybe like a year after I got her, we rescued. Hey, so I'm not sure what happened there. I lost half of the video. And when I was about to introduce Gohan,
and their story, I don't know how to disappear. So here are some of Luna's TikTok videos, and I hope you enjoy. And yeah, I'm sorry about that, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Later.